What's up, Timberwolves? I'm Daniel Dobson.
And I'm Harrison Bachman.
Welcome back to the best TV show around,
Timberwolf Tracks. We have a great episode planned for you guys today.
This week we have a question of the week, a biscuit challenge, and much more.
So sit back,
relax.
It's time for Timberwolf Tracks. Danny, look at this picture I drew.
Holy cow, Harry. You're such a good artist. You should join the art club.
Thanks, but I don't know much about art.
Good thing Brooklyn made us a promo video about it.
Anyone who is willing to create is welcome to Art Club. Like, there's no skill level limit, there's no like qualifications you have to meet. As long as you're respectful and you wish to create, you're welcome to join Art Club.
It's a very great environment with a lot of friendly people. We have a bunch of different chats that you could like just go and talk to people if you need to. And then we have a lot of fun events we do and a lot of things we have planned. So it's just a very good experience overall.
It's definitely helped me get out of my comfort zone and actually finish projects. It's been really nice and just a fun place to talk with other people.
Art Club is my safety blanket. It is a group of people where I feel completely safe to express any bit of art that I do. And while I may not be the most talented person there, they make me feel like I am.
Everyone should join Art Club. It's really fun.
Art Club's a lot of fun. People should join it.
Those are amazing.
Speaking of clubs, Kale, Jonathan, and Xander interviewed some of the club presidents.
Roll the clip.
Hi, my name is Alton Martinez. I'm a senior this year at Norman North, and I am president of the Hispanic and Latinx Culture Club. I've been president since my junior year. I think I wanted to kind of take lead for the club, mainly because I felt like I wanted the school to know a little bit more about my culture. Every year we try to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month, which starts September 15th and ends October 15th. So we usually kind of decorate the school with some cool stuff, you know, people, biographies of people, and just other culture stuff. We also change the bell songs to Hispanic or Latinx artists. We also work with outside organizations that kind of help empower Hispanic or Latin youth. One is called Latinos Unidos 405. They work to help high school students get into higher education. We hold meetings once a month during upperclassmen lunch on Thursdays. We also bring food for people just so they don't starve. And we kind of just talk about what it's like to be Hispanic or Latin in America. We also, you know, hit up topics that are important to our culture, like immigration or music, religion, things like that. So.
Hi guys, I'm Kennedy Carlson. I'm a sophomore and I'm president of Christians on Campus. Whenever I was asked to be president this year, I accepted the role because high school can be a hard place for students to share their beliefs about religion or just their spiritual beliefs. And as a Christian, I believe that we should be able to have a place to talk comfortably with other people that share our beliefs. What we do for Christians on Campus is we meet every Friday at 8:30 a.m. in C201. And what we do is every week we have a different student speaker, totally optional, and they just talk about their faith and their testimony to the rest of the club and just share what they feel that they want to share with the group. And something new that we're going to try this year is to bring in guest speakers, whether that's youth ministers, youth pastors, stuff like that. Meetings are every Friday at 8:30 a.m. in C201. If you have any questions about joining, you can email me, but really all you have to do is show up.
My name is Andrick Short. I'm a sophomore. I'm president of the Disc Golf Club, and I started it because I was passionate about it. I started the Disc Golf Club at Norman North because I liked playing but didn't have any kids my age to play with. And so our club focuses on just kind of getting together and hanging out. This year we're going to try to enter some tournaments, so that'll be fun. And we just meet every Monday after school and play at Griffin Disc Golf Park, and we start to play during lunch. If you'd like to get involved in the club, you can go talk to Mr. Simke in C207 or email me at andricks@normanps.org.
My name is Cole Cordes. I'm a senior, and I wanted to be the president of Key Club because there was no one else doing it and the club would have died, so I decided to step in because it's a service-based club and I was wanting to help the community and keep the club alive at North. So basically, Key Club is a service-based club. We do volunteer work in the community, volunteer work here at North, various organizations that need us. It's an international club, it's not only here. So to get involved in Key Club, you can go to one of our monthly meetings or you can fill out the QR code. We have various signs hanging around North and super easy. It's only 5 hours of service. If you have any more questions, you can either email me or look at our Instagram for more information.
Man, what a segment.
Hey Danny, did you go watch the senior night volleyball games by any chance?
Nah, I was busy.
Oh, well here's a recap Lindsay made. Wow, I got chills. Hey, speaking of chills, you know we got a new secretary principal?
Oh yeah, Mrs. Isaac.
Here's an interview with her by Gretchen and Julian.
Hello, this is Gretchen.
And Julianne. And today we interviewed Mrs. Isaac, the new principal secretary.
Hi guys, my name is Kennedy Isaac. I'm the principal secretary here at Norman North. I'm located in the main office next to Dr. Garrett. A day in the life as a principal secretary changes day by day. I start my mornings with helping kids make sure they have their IDs on and getting new IDs if they don't. And then it just changes day by day, helping Dr. Garrett make sure we get things at Norman North all squared away. What I love about Norman North, I grew up in Norman, so I'm already a Normanite, and I just take a lot of pride here in the school. I love the school spirit, all the fun stuff that we do, and the academics. It's just a great place. I like to work with high school students because there's always something new going on, whether they're having a good day or bad day. There's just always some way that I can help the kids, and I love that. A great memory here at Norman North that I've had so far would be the Crosstown Clash. It was a night to remember with all the rain and helping kids in the North Gym at Norman High. You know, Tigers on one side, Timberwolves on one side. It was a whole little Crosstown Clash in itself just for the rain delay, and it was a night I will never forget. Advice I'd give to a high school student, just always keep your head up. Sometimes you're stressed with class or, you know, friends, fights. Just keep your head up, you know. Tomorrow's always a new day, and, you know, we're here to learn and have fun. To de-stress during any time in my day, I'm a snacker. I love Diet Dr. Pepper and candy, and that's kind of my go-to. I just like to snack on things, and that's a de-stressor for me because I love food.
This was Interviewing Mrs. Isaac with Julianne
and Gretchen. I hope you learned something new about the Norman North staff.
What an exquisite gal she is.
Man, I love fun words like exquisite, breathtaking, and gorgeous.
Hey, that reminds me of Lily and Lennon in their segment,
Question of the Week.
Today we're doing question of the week.
We ask students what the most fun word to say is.
Let's go.
What's the most fun word to say?
Shenanigans. Pookie.
That's a good one.
What word is the most fun to say?
I'm gonna go with philanthropy. I don't know how to, it took me a really long time to learn how to say that word. I always said philanthropy, so I would really mess up in spud.
Perfect.
Yeah.
What's the most fun word to say?
Bozo.
Why? Because it goes with everything.
What word is the most fun to say?
Super.
Why?
I don't just say it a lot.
So. Yeah, perfect. Okay. Thank you.
What is the most fun word to say?
Snuffleupagus.
Oh. Whoa. Hey, what's the most fun word to say?
Probably.
And what's your favorite word? Joseph Foot.
Well, it's funny you asked that, Harrison, because I just learned a new word yesterday. I can't pronounce it, but it is my favorite. If you don't mind, I'll just read it here. I'll try. Yes. Esophagogastroduodenoscopy, which is a 26-letter word, meaning they stick a scope down into your intestines and stomach. So, that is my new favorite word.
I'd hate to have a gastroesophageal.
It was not fun. It was not fun. But at least I did yesterday, unfortunately, and that is how I learned this new word.
Very cool. Thank you for the information.
Indeed. No problem. Thank you.
What is the most fun word to say?
Flabbergasted.
Oh, that's a good one.
What are your favorite words to say?
Monkey.
Pimpin.
Ape.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're so very welcome.
Thank you.
The Industrial Revolution.
Yes. Today's the day, Collins.
Alright. What's your favorite word to say?
Voluptuous.
That's a good one.
I know.
What's your favorite word to say?
Grasshopper.
I like that one. What's your favorite word to say?
Beautiful.
What's your favorite word to say?
Annoying.
Can you write that one on the board?
No.
It's pretty annoying to not do.
Sorry.
Here we go. Hey! What's your name?
Harper.
What's the most fun word to say? Come on.
Sausage.
What is your most favorite word to say?
Well, I like to basically just look at the students and say, what's up, doc?
Yeah, I think you've done that in a class I was in.
Yeah,
it's great.
Quite a bit. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Man, that segment slaps.
Just Like Adventures with Wolfie, brought to you by Drew and Will.
Breaking news! Reports are in that Tiger has been hospitalized after his fight with the beloved Wolfie West. No one knows where to find Wolfie, and the question everyone is asking, where is he, and what will he do next?
I have received breaking news. Our arch rival, Tiger, is in the hospital. I'm gonna go check it out.
Can I see him?
Sorry, no visitors at this time. He's in critical condition.
I don't think you know who I am. You do not know who you're talking to. I'm Wolfie West. Tiger, it's me, Wolfie.
Wolfie, I've been meaning to talk to you.
What do you want to talk about?
I'm a changed man. I go by Spud now. Letter writing is on October 1st from 10 to 2 in the CCC. All Spud committee members are required to be there.
Spud, who are you talking to?
Huh?
Man, all this talking about letter writing has really made me want to play some volleyball. I didn't see you there. Did you know that there is a varsity volleyball tournament September 30th in Mustang? Be sure to show up and show out, right, Spud?
Who are you talking to?
Hey, who's that?
Identify yourself.
Who are you?
I'm the Norman North cheerleading coach. You guys look good at volleyball. You should try out for cheer.
Well, I don't know who you are, but you are wearing an ID, so we can trust you.
Come with me to cheer tryouts. Grab on. Now let's see what you've got.
I miss you and I cannot change you, so I must.
Fill the Bucket Powder Puff is this Sunday. Come out to see your newest member of the Norman North cheer team, which is Wolfie West.
Spud, what are you doing?
You took everything from me. I'm Tiger again.
Welcome to the Huddle. We're your hosts this week. I'm Kason Lee.
And I'm Harrison Utley. Let's take a look at last week's football game against UConn Bellers. Norman North lost in a close game to UConn Bellers. This would give them their first loss of the season, and UConn the first win of the season. Austin Vincent led the team with 20 tackles, and Zay Rogers had a blocked field goal that returned for a touchdown. And JV also lost in a close game, JV losing at the end of the game with a two-point conversion.
September 17th. The cross-country team had a meet in Missouri. We placed 9th out of 40th, and most runners hit good PR times.
Volleyball played four games this week. They beat Union and Norman High Monday, Tuesday, but lost to Choctaw and Ponca City Wednesday, Thursday.
Volleyball played two games, against Stillwater and Evan Memorial. In the Stillwater game, we wiped the floor with them, beating them 3-0. In the Evan Memorial game, we fought a hard battle and lost in five sets.
The senior captain, Riley Roberts, stating, "We came together as a team and it really showed the results." Here's an interview with head coach Faith Avalos.
My name is Faith Avalos and I coach varsity volleyball here at Norman North.
And how long have you been coaching for?
This is my second year at Norman North. I've been coaching for about 12 years total.
And how has that impacted your life?
So coaching is my life. It's my favorite identity. It's my favorite role that I get to play. Mainly I just love the game so much that being able to coach it, get people better at it, and learn through all the opportunities that volleyball offered me is everything.
And how did you get to Norman North?
So I was working at UCO and had spent a lot of time recruiting Norman North. And then through that process was talking with my mentor, just trying to figure out what next steps are, and I figured out I wanted to stay in Oklahoma, maybe wanted to work with some younger athletes, develop them, and so this position opened up and I just kind of ran for it. I knew about it from recruiting Laurie, and I'm very pleased to be here.
And what are your goals for this season?
So our goals for this season are really high. We're trying to win that state championship. We were in second in state last year, finished just shy of our goal, and so this year I'd love for us to be able to have an opportunity to get that final goal for these seniors. If anything, I just want them to finish playing as hard as they can and having the most fun.
Okay, thank you.
That's it for the Huddle.
Tune in next week for more.
Ready, break!
Man, what an episode.
Indeed.
Thanks for watching episode 2 of this year's Timberwolf Tracks.
Make sure to tune in next time.
Same Timberwolf time.
Same Timberwolf place.
That was so-
good.
Dark in the city and the night is a wire. Steam in the subway and the earth is a fire. Oh yeah. Woman, you want me, so give me a sign. I'll do my Edom just a moment. Dream high.